गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ मुकेश यादव फ्रॉम यस कॉन्वेंट सीनियर सेकेंडरी स्कूल सौरमऊ सुल्तानपुर। टूडे माई टॉपिक इज इम्पल्स रिलेटेड टू फिजिक्स, सो आई डिस्कस अबाउट द इम्पल्स। इम्पल्स इज अ इम्पल्सिव फोर्स व्हेन अ लार्ज फोर्स अप्लाइड ऑन अ बॉडी फॉर अ शॉर्ट टाइम then a small yeah we can say that a finite change in momentum, so we can discuss about the impulse. When a large force applied on a body then a finite change in momentum is called impulse. So we can say that when a large force applied on an object, a finite change in momentum is known as impulse. It is represented by J, capital J, and it is a vector quantity, and it is a vector quantity. And its formula J is equal to F into T. Yani ki when a large force applied on an object for a short time, then we get impulse. So the unit of impulse is equal to the unit of force is Newton and the unit of time is second. So we can say that the unit of impulse is Newton into second, or we can change it into MKS. The unit of MKS is equal to kilogram meter per second square, and the unit of time is second. So finally we get the unit is equal to kilogram meter per second. So the CGS unit is equal to kilogram in gram and meter centimeter and time also second. So the CGS unit of impulse is equal to gram centimeter per second. So we can see here the units of impulse. So we get a special theorem about the momentum and impulse, known as impulse momentum theorem. So we can discuss about the impulse momentum theorem. So we can discuss about the impulse momentum theorem. Now we can discuss about the impulse momentum theorem. As we know that according to Newton's second law, F vector is equal to dp upon dt, where dp is known as change in momentum. Yeah, according to Newton's, we know that the rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to applied force. So we get F is equal to dp upon dt. If a body change from time 0 to t, then its momentum also change p1 to p2. So we can Say, look here, and it is calculated. We get dP is equal to F into dT. dP is equal to F into dT. Now integrating the above equation. Now integrating the above equation with proper limit. So we get integration dP is equal to integration of F into dT. Here the limit of momentum is P1 to P2 and the limit of time 0 to T. So we get the integration of dP is P. The integration of dP is P and limit P1 to P2 and F is constant. So we get out of this, we get here T, limit T1 to 0 to T. Now solving the above equation, we get P2 minus P1 is equal to F, upper limit minus lower limit is known as upper limit minus lower limit T minus 0. Now finally we get F into T is equal to P2 minus P1. The FT is known as the FT is known as impulse and P2 minus P1 is known as change in momentum. This equation is known as impulse momentum theorem. So we discuss about the topic impulse and impulse momentum theorem. Now we want to solve our questions about the impulse. Now the student, we can solve our numerical based on the impulse momentum theorem. If a body of mass 20 kg and excited a force on an object on the body and excited a force on an object on an object on an object with a force of 144 newton for a short time 20 seconds, then find the velocity of the object. Then find the velocity of the object. Then find the velocity of the object. Okay. Now solving, we given that the mass of object M is equal to 20 kg and moment force F is equal to 144 newton and the time t is equal to 20 seconds. and its initial velocity u is equal to 0, v is equal to, we can find the velocity of the object. We know that ft is equal to m into v minus u. From given value we can solve F 144 into 20 is equal to 20 into v minus 0, because initial velocity is 0. So we get 144 into 20 is equal to 20 v, or v is equal to 144 into 20 upon 20. To 20 and 20 cancel, we get the velocity of the object 144 meter per second. So the velocity of the object is 144 meter per second. Okay, student, so thank you for this, and next topic is created soon. Thank you, have a nice day.